And as we continue talking about vaccinations, there is a little bit of hesitancy. And now there's questions on whether or not they have an effect on women's reproductive health. Joining us now to talk more about this, Director of Maternal Quality and Safety Program for Hartford HealthCare, Dr. Elizabeth Deckers. Hi, doctor. Thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you for asking me.
So we want to start out by saying, is there any validity to these concerns? Should women worry, or is this a myth?
So there are a lot of rumors and myths currently circulating on social media about the vaccines causing infertility. And what's important to know is that there's absolutely no scientific evidence that supports this. The problem right now is that we don't, because pregnant women weren't included in the phase three trials, we have a bit of a void of information regarding safety and efficacy. However, there's no theoretical reason to think that these vaccines should cause a problem for women's reproductive health.
And as we continue talking about pregnant women who have maybe contracted COVID-19, what is known about their experiences and any of the medical complications that they had?
Yeah, absolutely. You're correct. Many pregnant women have gotten COVID-19. In fact, as of last week, approximately 57,000 pregnant women in the United States have had COVID-19. And this is something we actually do know something about, in that we know that pregnant women are more likely than non-pregnant women to be at risk for getting severe disease from COVID-19. And they're also more likely than non-pregnant women to be admitted to an ICU, need breathing support, or even die. And again, as of last week, 71 mothers have died in the United States from complications of COVID-19.
Wow, what a sad statistic to talk about. And if a woman is planning to start a family, what should she know about the vaccine?
So I think it's important to know, number one, that there's no scientific evidence that supports the myths on social media, that we do understand that there are increased risks to pregnant women from COVID-19. And so every woman needs to balance her personal risk of COVID-19 with what is known about the vaccine right now. And it really should be a conversation with your healthcare provider. The other thing you should know is that the mRNA in the vaccine is very short acting and doesn't cause any genetic changes in cells. So we think that ultimately this will be proven to be very safe and effective in pregnancy, but everyone needs to balance those risks until we have a little bit more information.
Okay, Dr. Elizabeth Deckers, thank you so much for taking the time and talking with us today.
Thank you.